In this module, we are going to discuss about how the multi-party system has emerged in India, how there has been a transition from one dominant party system to multi-party system, and how the multi-party system has led to emergence of coalition politics in India. That is the gist of this module. But in this module, we focus mainly on how the multi-party system and the coalition system evolved in India, and how did it evolve till the period of 1990s, when we find that there is a transition in nature of the coalition politics. So when we refer to the party system in colonial India, it was the Congress Party, which started as a platform, went on to become a pressure group, and then became a movement party during the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi. So Congress Party became a colossal party. It dominated the national political imagination, and other parties were there, like the Communist Party of India was also formed in 1925. We had Akali Dal, which was formed in 1920. We had other parties, Congress Socialist Parties and other parties, but these parties really did not really dominate the political scenario. It was the Congress Party which emerged as the ruling party and also as the dominant party. In fact, when we refer to the writings of Rajni Kothari, Myron Wiener and Morris Jones, they all have spoken about one dominant party system, Congress system. They have talked about how the Congress Party dominated the political scenario in India after independence, as before independence also, in not only in electoral terms, but also in ideological terms. So Congress was not only winning elections at the center and at the state level, as Paul Brass argues that 2/3 of the seats were won by the Congress in the first three general elections, 1952, 1957 and 1962. It also dominated the ideological space. So Congress Party was the one dominant party in the sense that it represented the ideological consensus. It stood for welfare, socialism, secularism, federalism. It represented the consensus which had emerged during the freedom struggle of India. So because the Congress Party was such a hegemonic party, it was such an electorally dominant party, so the period between 1947 to 1967, you don't find that any other party was able to challenge Congress electorally. It was only in 1967 election that the Congress lost power in as many as 9 states. And the state parties came up, and there was also an attempt on the part of the opposition parties like Bharatiya Jansangh, the Praja Socialist Party, Sanyukt Socialist Party, to form like a coalition government. So there were 9 states where you had a first wave of coalition government which came up in 9 states, though these coalition governments did not really survive long, because the coalitions were formed only on the basis of anti-congressism and also in pursuit of political power. There was no ideological interlinkages or ideological commonality or ideological consensus among all these coalition making parties. And there was no agreement also which party would have a preeminent position. So these coalition governments collapsed one by one, and the Congress was able to come back to power both in 1971 Lok Sabha election and in the state elections in 1972. So the second wave of coalition comes in the form of Janata Party experiment. Jayaprakash Narayan in 1977 was able to manage to bring many opposition parties, including Bharatiya Jansangh, Congress for Democracy, the Socialist Parties, they all came together and they merged their identity into Janata Party. And Janata Party, as we all know, it won the election in 1977 election. So Janata Party, though it was a one party rule, I mean, you can't say that Janata Party had not really identified itself as a single party. It had a single party registration and it had a party symbol and all, but in reality it was very much a coalition party. In fact, there is another argument also which is very interesting, and it says that though the Congress was the dominant party in the period between 1952 to 1967, but the Congress was also a coalition party in the sense that within the Congress you had the people from different ideological leanings. You had the left oriented people, you had the right oriented people, and also the those who believed in the centrist ideology. So Congress was in a way umbrella party, as Paul Brass tells it us, that it was an umbrella party because there was a social coalitional support base, upper caste, lower caste, minorities, they all supported the Congress, the left wing politicians, right wing politicians, they all supported, and that's why the opposition parties were also willing to cooperate with the Congress party, and they wanted to influence the policy making decisions. So we can say that 1967 and 1977 were the watershed years when the coalition politics came into prominence. But then as we see that the Congress again manages to come back, like it was able to come back in 1971, in 1980 also Congress again won the Lok Sabha elections, and even in the state Congress was able to come back. So 1980 to 1990 period, we can say that there was coalition government, but the Congress was the at the center of the party system. So the even when the opposition parties came together, they came together to defeat the Congress. So it was anti-Congressism which became the basis for the opposition politics. But then we don't have really very credible example of successful coalition experiment in India, though there was a coalition government in Punjab in 1977 when Akalis and the Janata Party formed the coalition government. We had a coalition government in West Bengal. We had the coalition government in Tamil Nadu. At that time it was state of Madras. So we have certain examples. Pepsu is another example where we had a coalition government. Another example would be Kerala in 1960 elections, when the Congress party had an alliance with many other parties to form a coalition government. But as such, you can say in this module, as we have we are going to discuss, that between 1947 to 1990, coalition governments were few and they were not really having very successful career.
This paper is titled Indian Politics 2, and the module title is Multi-Party System and the Coalition Politics in India from its emergence till 1990s. So in this module, we talk about the way coalition politics has evolved in India right since the colonial days to 1990. So we have divided the period into different phases, how the parties have evolved and how the party coalitions have come up. So the first phase, we talk about the colonial India. We find that in colonial India, for the first time, we had the coalitional experiment, which came up in 1946, when after the elections which took place, the interim government under the leadership of Nehru was formed. And in this coalitional government, it was not only the Congress, but also the Muslim League and the Hindu Mahasabha, which were the constituent of the interim government. Then after independence, when we refer to the coalitional experiment, then we can refer to the Pepsu. Pepsu was a state which was formed on the basis of the merger of the princely state, erstwhile princely states of Punjab, into a separate state other than Punjab. So Pepsu was formed in 1948 and it remained in existence till 1956. So in Pepsu, there was a first coalition government, coalition of a non-Congress party government was formed in 1952. So that would be the first example of the coalition government. Another example of the coalition or the parties coming together would be 1969, when Swatantra Party, Bharatiya Kisan Dal and Jansangh, they came together to support the candidature of Neelam Sanjeeva Reddy. Neelam Sanjeeva Reddy was fighting as independent candidate for presidentship, Congress candidate against the candidature of V.V. Giri, Varaha Venkatraman Giri. V.V. Giri was independent candidate and Neelam Sanjeeva Reddy was the candidate of the Congress party, but he got the support of other parties also in 1969. Then in 1974, again Bharatiya Lok Dal was formed as a constituent of various parties. So Bharatiya Lok Dal came as a result of the merger of Swatantra Party, Utkal Congress, BKD, SSP and Rashtriya Lok Chintan Dal. This coalition also did not really survive much, and a tenure of these coalitional success, coalition making was short-lived and the experiment did not survive for long. Now here we can say that under the leadership of Jayaprakash Narayan, an opposition movement gathered momentum, and the congressmen who insisted on dialogue with Jayaprakash Narayan were expelled from the Congress, and so Jayaprakash Narayan was instrumental in forming the coalitional government, which was coalitional party and which went by the name of Janata Party. And in the Janata Party you had lots of parties coming together, and they came together to challenge the dominance of the Congress, and they also came together against the imposition of emergency in India. Now we come to the second wave of coalition government. So we can see that the first experiment of the coalition government was made in Madras, the then state of Madras, which is now known as Tamil Nadu. Madras, Travancore, Cochin and Pepsus. Now we come to, in 1957, the coalition government of the Congress party and Ganatantra Parishad came into being in the state of Madras, which was in existence till 1961. In Kerala also, coalition of the Congress, PSP and the Muslim League came to power between 1960 to 1964. As we know, 1957 Communist Party had come to power in Kerala, but in 1959 the party was dismissed, a president rule was imposed and the elections took place, in which the Congress came to power in coalition with PSP and the Muslim League. Then in the post-1967 period, again the SVD governments were formed in various states such as Punjab, Bihar and Orissa, West Bengal and Kerala. So it was like a large scale of defection also took place from the Congress party, and this helped the opposition party. Janata Party government would be the first coalition government at the union, where Janata Party was also, as we would see in the following paragraph, we would see that even Janata Party was a party which was a result of a coalition of many parties. So basically there was attempt on the part of the opposition party to come together on the platform of anti-congressism. To understand this reality, which has been characterized as the dominant party system or the Congress system, whereby the Congress party was winning power both at the center as well as at the state level in electoral terms, and also party had immense organizational strength, presence all over India, and so the state parties were reduced to the level of a pressure group. James Manner argued that Congress was an umbrella party which was really dominating all other non-Congress parties, and there were various ways in which the Congress occupied not only the broad center of the political spectrum but most of the left and the right as well. This relegated the opposition party to the margin of the political and party system. So this would be a point, this would be an argument about the dominance of the Congress thanks to its efficient party organization, its all-encompassing ideology, its social coalitional support base, which would figure again and again in the writings of James Manner, also in the writings of Paul Brass, then Rajni Kochhari, Maurice Jones and many other analysts of the Indian party system. Even now this kind of position is very much there. One can also refer to the Rudolph, who also talked about that how the traditional elements of the caste system assisted the development of the modern representative politics in India. And the Congress was very smart in politicizing the identity politics and giving it a modern culture. Politicization of caste is something which has been argued by Rajni Kothari. So, it would be wrong to attribute during this period in Indian politics that there was no coalition. The coalition was there, but the coalition was present within the one dominant party. So, Congress in itself was an umbrella party. Congress itself was a kind of coalitional party in the sense that the people belonging to different ideological moorings, they all came together within the Congress party. The fourth general elections in 1967 led to a replacement of a single dominant party system by the multi-party system. The Congress lost power in as many as 9 states. These states were Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal, Orissa, now which is known as Odisha, and then also Tamil Nadu and Kerala. So there were 9 states where the Congress was unable to come back to power. And in fact, as you know, in Tamil Nadu, they have never been able to come back to power since 1967. And in West Bengal also, till since 1977, they have remained out of power. So there were many non-Congress government, and most of these non-Congress governments were coalitional government. So for the first time in 1967, the non-Congress parties, they came together and they formed a coalitional government. And like for example, in Bihar, there was a SVD, Sanyukt Vidhayak Dal, was formed, and it consisted of so many parties like SSP, PSP, Jansan, CPI, and also the Jan Kranti Dal. So they came together to form majority and form the government. In Punjab also, CPM, Akali Dal, Akali Dal Master Group, and CPI, Jansan, and the Republican Party, they formed the United Front Government. So there were many other examples. Orissa would be another example, Kerala would be another example, West Bengal would be another example, where the Bangla Congress and the CPM and 14 other parties would form the coalition. So basically, these parties came together not on any common ideological plan. They came together basically to not allow the Congress party come to power. So it was anti-Congressism which was basically guiding the formation of all these coalition government. And as I said earlier also, that it was hardly any surprise that these coalitional arrangements did not survive long. Not on any common ideological plan, they came together basically to not allow the Congress party come to power. So it was anti-Congressism which was basically guiding the formation of all these coalition government. And as I said earlier also, that it was hardly any surprise that these coalitional arrangements did not survive long. So we come to the 1971 and 1972 elections. As I said, 71 Lok Sabha elections, 72 state level elections. The Congress dominance was again established, and there was a decline of the coalitional government. And in fact, with the coming to power of Indira Gandhi, there was a centralized leadership style, and this centralized leadership style did not really allow the coalitional arrangement, the possibility of any coalitional arrangement. And the populist politics of Indira Gandhi ensured that the Congress was coming to power not only at the center but also at the state level. Under the leadership of Jayaprakash Narayan, an opposition movement gathered momentum, and the congressmen who insisted on dialogue with Jayaprakash Narayan were expelled from the Congress. And so Jayaprakash Narayan was instrumental in forming the coalitional government, which was coalitional party, and which went by the name of Janata Party. And in the Janata Party, you had lots of parties coming together, and they came together to challenge the dominance of the Congress, and they also came together against the imposition of emergency in India. So basically, the beginning of the formal coalition at the center starts with the Janata Party, which was basically a conglomerate of erstwhile centralist and socialist forces. And the Janata Party was able to win as many as 292 seats in the 1977 elections. And the CPM also got 22 seats and CPI got 7 seats because CPI was punished because of its whole alliance with the Congress party. But there was also this problem about the prime ministerial ambitions of many Janata Party leaders. Though Morarji Desai was the prime minister, but then there was also the other two contenders, Jagjivan Ram and also Charan Singh, who also wanted to become the prime minister. So it has been basically the coalitional system which came into existence in 1977, but this experiment also did not last long. The breakup within the Janata Party and many parties, especially the fight was about the Janson members, erstwhile Janson members, insisting on retaining their membership of Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh, which was not acceptable to the other constituents of the Janata Party. But there was also this problem about the prime ministerial ambitions of many Janata Party leaders. During this period, India witnessed a situation where relatively stable multi-party system at the regional level found themselves within an unstable multi-party system at the national level. So it all happened that within 2 years that the Janata Party collapsed and it was back to the 1980 election, the back to the one party government which came into existence at the center. Then we have another situation that for quite long period it was the Congress party which was basically ruling at the center when Indira Gandhi came back to power in 1980, and also at the state level when the Janata Party governments were dismissed and the fresh elections were called, then the Congress came to power in most of the states.
Let me summarize. In this module, we basically discussed about the Congress system. We discussed about how one party, Congress party, was able to dominate the party system in India for quite long period. And we also saw that how in 1967 general elections, when the elections took place for the Lok Sabha and the state assembly elections simultaneously, the Congress party losing political power in as many as 9 states led to the emergence of coalition politics in a real sense. And then we also discussed in this module that how in 1977 the success of Janata Party was basically a success of a coalition politics which was led by Jayaprakash Narayan. We also find that 1970s was the period when many peasant caste, they started asserting themselves. Many hitherto dormant identity groups on the caste basis, or you had this backward caste politics or Kisan politics which was led by Chaudhary Charan Singh, it paved the way for challenge to the Congress, because Congress was accused of not really providing space to the people belonging to the backward classes, peasant classes. It was considered that the Congress leadership was dominated by the upper caste. So generally you have the period that you have many parties coming up which were really supported by the middle caste and the peasant caste. And so these parties emerged and they put up a challenge to the Congress party, and gradually on the plank of anti-Congressism, then on the basis of Kisan politics, helping out the poor farmers and the middle farmers, and then the reservation issue for the backward caste, all these provided the basis for the emergence of many state level parties. And gradually, because the Congress lost the support of many segments, especially this middle segment of the society, so now you had a situation by 1990s, by late 80s, that now you had many state level parties emerging in a big way at the state level and putting up challenge to the Congress party. So that is something which we should consider very important, because 1970s would be the period, and then 1980s when the basis for the foundation for challenge to the Congress was getting prepared, and there was an emergence of the identity based parties, the parties which were claiming that the Congress was neglecting the rural sector, Congress was not really giving representation to the middle caste politicians. There was no institutional mechanism to allow the middle caste, the farmers, to get a space in the Congress organization. The organizational and the ideological decline of the Congress also, especially under the leadership of Mrs. Indira Gandhi, also paved the way that many ambitious leaders, influential leaders, they left the Congress, like Dev Rajars, you can mention. They formed their own parties, they formed the state level parties. So the rise of regionalism, the rise of the politicization of the caste, and the rise of the Kisan politics, these three factors, they played very important role in the rise of the smaller parties, state level parties. Even at the national level, we had the Janata Party and then Janata Dal and RJD, JDU, they all came into existence in 1990s. But the background was, the groundwork was very much prepared in the 70s itself.